Hey all, Goda Govinda, this is Madhavilasya from Channel ML. So today we are going to discuss about how to respect others in terms of profession, race and everything. I mean, I'm going to focus only on the profession, because even though we all say that, oh, I respect each other, I know few people does have the feeling, does have the prideness that, just because they're having a white collar job, that is the best job and everything. So I would like to share one of my experience where I was working in IT industry for 13 years, and due to my health issues, I have to quit the job, of course with my husband's support. And then my husband only made me to push my capability to see to just try out other different jobs other than IT, because IT is a very glamorous job. What happened was, some people was trying to put me down, saying, oh, I mean, you're working here, I mean, you are earning this much of amount of money in IT, and they were trying to put me down always. So a request I have for everyone is, for some reason, if a person has to quit from from a bigger position to whatever it is, it doesn't matter. At the end of the day, work is work, job is job. You don't have to underestimate, a job, stating like this job is better than that. Of course, pay-wise it might be different, but bless you. It's better not to underestimate any job. If somebody's working at Walmart, somebody's working at a waitress at the restaurant, or they might be low paid, but they might be going through various things. Example, the students, where they might need the money to pay their semester fees and everything. So when I was searching job, that's what I understood. Even I watched few videos, where they mentioned about, how we should never ask for what are your son working and everything, because that is not an ethical act, that's very unprofessional. So if somebody is working, oh yeah, okay, they're working. And if we don't have to be nosy and peep into others' personal things. And also giving them unnecessary advice, like, oh, you are in this industry, why did you come over here? I mean, these are all unnecessary talks. Rather, we can try to help them by giving them more confidence, which my husband is always doing. Of course, sometimes I do feel low, because I used to get I used to make more money than I'm getting right now, but then my husband is always trying to point me to to look at the other side, to look the positive aspects, in I'm not stressful as before, I'm taking rest, I'm feeling much better now. Even though I'm not making money as before, I'm very happy. So he's only making me to see the positive aspect of the life, rather than thronging onto the negative thing. I mean, it's very easy to say, but just a request, let's not judge anybody based on their occupation or work or job, because that's not a good thing. That's what mentioned by Sri Rukmini Krishna and Bhagavad Gita also. So that is my suggestion or a request. Because I know it's very hard, but I think if you practice, it's very easy. If somebody is working at as a waitress or anything, let's respect everyone. Because I know one of the person was working as a waiter, and one of the customer threw the hot pasta into his face. He just trashed it. I mean, those things should be really condemned, because it's not ethical. I mean, of course customers are paying, same time, same way, even the waiters are also being paid to serve the person. I mean, nothing comes free. So in that case, for some reason, if there is a delay in getting something, whether it's whatever it is, Amazon package or anything like that, let's try to understand, something. I mean, let's try to understand, let's try to be polite and kind, and just let's say thank you for them, whether
Let's call
firefighters or
them.
cops. Yeah, firefighters or whatever it is, like, you know,
and
the
please.
movers and everything. Movers and everything. So let's try to respect others. Just put yourself into the situation by, you know, think like, okay, if I'm in the waiter position, how would I want to be treated? Likewise, like, you know, we should treat others. It's not the vice versa.
And you should always wait if someone is speaking. Only just speak when the person is done talking.
Okay, yeah. Thank you. So that's why, like, I know we all get mad at all the times, but it is possible to control our anger, our madness unnecessarily, because, like, my husband always says, like, you know, anger is like salt. I mean, like, you know, if it is less, it doesn't taste good. If it is more, also, it doesn't taste good. So only if it is shown at the right time, you know, like, that's when your angerness will be valued, rather than, you know, rather than if you're getting angry or getting mad all the time, then people will never value your madness or value any of the emotions. But, you know, like, if you try to show your anger at the right time, in the right place, you know, like, people will understand, okay, this person, like, you know, will not get angry or not get mad all the time. So if this person is getting mad, then something is wrong. So then people will understand that. So likewise, like, you know, we have to give respect to others' dignity as well, and try to put ourselves in their position, situation, and try to think. So even if you are getting, like, parcel, 5 minutes delay, or if you're going to a shop, you're not able to find anything, the associate are not able to find anything, that's okay. You know, like, let's be calm and, you know, like, try to respect each other and never... Never, like, you know, degrade anybody or grade anybody based on their work, occupation, or job.
Or taunt or sarcastic them.
Yes, we should never gossip or taunt others. Yeah, that's true. So that's another thing. So that's what I would like to share, because by keeping my experience, I know many of you would have faced this, but I just thought, like, I would just share mine so that there is always, like, you know, room for improvement. I do get mad, but with my husband's support and help, like, you know, I'm trying to, you know, like, deviate my anger into the right way by not showing, you know, like, all the time, rather showing it at the right time. So I hope you like this video. If you want any topics to be covered, like, please let me know. I mean, I'll be happy to help, of course, with my husband's support. You want to say that?
What?
Vaccinate yourself.
Also, vaccinate yourself and take like a bags.
Reusable.
Reusable bags when you come out. Take it. Then go to Govinda.
Okay, thank you. Go to Govinda. See you next time.